Well, let's take a closer look and see what we've got. Well, we've got plenty of gold circuit boards, gold-plated circuit boards, some edge connectors or fingers. We've got plenty of connectors. We've got some cinch connectors. Plenty of gas FETs, transistors, plenty of gold-plated chips with gold-plated legs. And a whole lot of gold SMA connectors. Boy, what are we gonna do with this? Well, let's get started. There you have it. Everything neatly organized and sorted in just one New York minute. Well, that's not entirely true. After many, many hours of tedious disassembly and many scrapes and cuts, we have the beginning of the process of reclaiming and refining gold. I would just like to take this opportunity for a moment to talk about gold. Like cats and catnip, gold can make some human beings crazy. There's a bunch of explanations for that, but it's very important to keep your emotions in check. Secondly, the gold you see on any given item is not as plentiful as you think it is. It always appears to be more than is truly there. So consider that as you look at your pile and think you are going to retire from it. The most important reason why I sort and group similar scrap in batches is because not all electronic scrap will be processed identical. The process I use is strictly dependent upon the material I have. Different material gets processed different ways. So if I put the work up front and sort everything out, the end result is cleaner and better, more efficient, and less waste. The second reason I sort and group the way I do is to get an accurate measurement in weight of which material gives me the best yield. So now let's zoom in and see some of the exact scrap that I have acquired. I was very fortunate to acquire these gold-plated circuit boards. As I said previously, there's usually not a lot of gold on these, but they're very easy to process. What makes these boards interesting is that they do not contain any components or solder. They are very, very easy to process. These boards, on the other hand, are gold-plated circuit boards from the 70s and 80s. I removed the components off of them, but the solder remains. Solder is the enemy of the refiner, specifically the tin in the solder, which is a nightmare for refiners. These will be processed a little differently. These are microwave amplifiers, pretty self-explanatory. Gold-plated parts on the inside, SMA connectors on the outside. A little more effort goes into removing the gold. Bag number one contains gold-plated SMA connectors. Not a whole lot of gold on those. The second bag is a gold push-in connector. Probably not a lot of gold on those. This third bag are microwave high-frequency components that we have not processed yet. This next bag kind of scares me a bit. The items in that bag are called gas FETs, which contain gallium arsenide. There's a lot of gold around it on the casing and on the shell, but the inside contains gallium arsenide, and I'm really not sure how to process those. The middle bag is just another gold-plated connector with pins. And this bag, of course, is a favorite, gold-plated chips, ceramic chips with gold-plated leads. This next bag on the left is gold-plated circulators. There's a small chance they're brass, but there's a simple test to discover which metal it is. The middle bag, more gold-plated connectors. And this bag is some sort of gold-plated diode assembly. This next bag on the left are gold-plated transistors, the larger version. You can see that I have a couple of them with the covers on, the top, the side, and the bottom. These here, all the metal covers have been removed to make it easier to process. This one here is an obvious gold fingers. I like to call them edge connectors. They're, in my opinion, the easiest to process. And this final bag are gold-plated transistors with gold-plated leads. We'll process those in the future. The last part of this video will be a bit repetitive, but it will show you some close-ups of my electronic scrap. Obviously, these are gold-plated chips, ceramic chips mostly, from different manufacturers that I've acquired over the years. These are going to be processed at a later date. These here are assorted connectors. These are called cinch connectors, and I've had very good luck with these gold-plated pins. They require an immense amount of work to break them and take them out. Very tedious work, but in the end, you can end up with quite a few pins. Words cannot describe what I have in front of me. I've acquired these items over the years from God knows where. And they will be processed very different and very separately from all the other scrap electronics. These here are SMA connectors. As I said earlier, they're very plentiful, but they have very little gold plating material on them. Not a whole lot of value here, but they do look nice. These are the gallium arsenic transistors that I mentioned earlier. I'm a bit spooked to process them because of the hazardous material inside. But what I did do is I took the covers off and I can process them separately. This is no hazard there. And this is what the gas FET looks like on the inside. So I'm going to do a little more research on this before I process them. I have plenty of these. These here are small gold-plated transistors. They're everywhere. I think they grow on trees. I have quite a few of them. They have gold leads and gold rims. I also have the older brother, which is a little larger with the metal cap. What I've done was I've taken the metal caps off, and you can see there's gold on the bottom. Well, gold on the bottom and gold on the top. This jar here are the larger ones with the tops removed. Whole lot of work. Here, I have an assortment of high-frequency devices which are gold-plated. These came from the microwave amplifiers that I illustrated earlier. And this is also some high-frequency devices that came from assorted electronics. Just kind of put them in the miscellaneous jar for now. These are called circulators. They're high-frequency circulators. They are most likely gold-plated, although I see no reason why the manufacturer would have gold-plated these. They could very well be brass, but what I'm encouraged by is that there really is no pitting or oxidation on them, and they're probably older than most people watching this YouTube video. These are very old potentiometers, variable resistors. There's not really much gold here. It's a lot of work, but if you have the time, you can smash them up and take the pins out. I just saved them for a rainy day. I've got maybe a couple of jars of these. These are very old high-power resistors from the 70s and 80s. What I found out is on the larger ones, the big fatties, they tend to have gold caps on them. You see, I removed some of the coating on the cap, and there's some gold plating under there. probably not a whole lot of value, but not all the resistors have them. The old fatter ones do, but they're only going to be on the end caps. So we save them and we'll process them at another time. And last but not least are the gold-plated circuit boards or PCBs. I purposely kept these for last because I believe they're the easiest to process. However, there's work involved. First thing I do is I remove all of the components, and I will show the how I do that in a future video. And when they're done, they look like that. Then I remove the solder in a different video, and when they're done, they look like that. And the basis of the next few videos is going to be on gold-plated circuit boards and the edge connectors or fingers on them. Some people snap the fingers off and process those because there's no secondary process of removing the solder. If you snap right here, that edge connector or finger can go right into the next acid bucket. Otherwise, all of this comes off and the solder comes off, and then the whole board goes into the acid bucket. And I will illustrate that in the next future videos. Thank you for watching.